Okay, so in this class, we will be doing this last two question of this test part 2N, 12.8. Okay, so let us start with question number 2, which is on page textbook 224, I think. So here, let us read the question first. Okay, let me read the question for us. Redraw the circuit diagram in 1. So let's look at the 1 that we've drawn in the previous class. Question number 1 there. 5, 8 and 12 are in series, so here 1 resistance, 5 ohms, next one 8 ohms, and the next one 12. They are in series, means one after another like this, and they're joined to a 6 volt 2 or 3, a battery of 3 cells 2 volts. So one cell here, long line, short line, that is 2 volt, then dash, long line, short line, then again 2 volt. Another cell is there. More than one cell is called battery. So these three combined is the battery, and each of them 2 volt. So total they will be having, by common sense also we know. Okay, look, you can do that later, I think, 2 volt each. Now, go back to the differences now. Go back to question 2. Putting ammeter to measure current. So usually, okay, switch, then ammeter is put in series, means an ammeter is an instrument to measure current. Okay, how much current is passing through the circuit? So if you put an ammeter like this, then that's called parallel, and ammeter should never be in parallel. So we cannot put the ammeter there after the resistances, or before the series we can put like that. So when we switch on the current will come out I. Whatever I is there will come out here, will come out finally, same everywhere is same in series. We learned this in the first class of this test 12D portion, right? So next, and voltmeter to measure potential difference across 12 ohm. So ammeter is to measure current, voltmeter is to measure potential difference, and voltmeter is always connected in parallel, means above or below like this. You also you can put, so we have chosen to put above, so that's fine. So this is the potential difference, let's say V3, voltmeter measuring the potential difference across 12, not 8 and 5. We have to keep that in mind. So here, as we do, question is saying, what would be the readings in ammeter and voltmeter? So ammeter means current, so I equal to question mark is there. Ammeter reading, this we have to find the total current in the circuit, which is basically the current. Then V3 equal to question mark is potential difference across the 12 ohm resistor, that is the voltmeter reading. Voltmeter reading will give you the potential difference across 12 ohm. That is what the question is asking. So let us start with this here. Since we need the R to get the I, see here, we need V and R. So this V is only for this one, total V I mean. So V is equal to here. Each of them have 2 volts and 3 cells are there. And each 2 volt means 6 volt is there. Total potential difference. So to find I, we need V. We found out, according to Ohm's law equation, to find I, we need V and R. So to find R, let RS, because the total has to be found out, be the total resistance of the first one here, 5 ohms, 8 ohms, 12 ohm, okay, 12 ohm resistors, as we can see, in they are in series because they're joined one after another. So because they're in series, we'll have to use this series formula. This is the total RS will be first one plus second one plus third one. So that will be 25. So this is RS. Now we got the R and the V, so easily you can find I. We are using this formula. That's how you do it. It's easy, okay? If you assess like that and go about, then easy. Using Ohm's law here, V is equal to I into R, the basic equation. But in our case, the V is okay, I is okay, R is mentioned as RS. So now that will imply we want I, emitter reading. So I means V, and this R shifted means coming down. So we may as well bring this side if you want. Is equal to V is 6 volt by RS is 25 ohms, as you can see here. So 6 divided by 25 is 0 point, then here 0, then 60, 25 to the 50, then 10 remain. 1 point means I can put 0 here, 25, 4 is 100. So we got our value for emitter reading. Sorry, 0.24 ampere. Okay, this one. So now, next we have to find the voltmeter reading, which is only concerning 12 ohm. So we write here V3. Okay, this is what we want. V3 equal to I into, okay, R. Okay, if you want, you can do like this also. Generally, put it V is equal to I into R. We know that. Since then, our V is the V3 over the 12 ohm. Our I is I, that's fine. Our R is here. You look here, you'll get your answer. Okay, if you want, you write here to calculate potential difference across 12 ohm. Second part of the question, voltmeter reading, resistor. So this ohm means resistance. So this particular resistance is now 12 ohms. So we can write using Ohm's law. This way also is okay. This is better, I think. V equal to I into R. So I is I, V is V3 in our case, and the R is, we're talking about a 12 ohm and not the total, not the RS. Okay, so this is here I, just now we got 0.24 ampere into 12. So see here, I ohms. So here, if you multiply 0.24 to 12, we're going to get here, okay, 48.42, so 882, so two decimal places, so 1, 2 left, so 2.88, and SI unit of potential difference is volt, meaning ampere into ohm. Just not memory that SI unit of potential difference is ohms. So this is our second answer, first answer. So we can write here your answers here. Therefore, question is asking ammeter reading, which is nothing but the current I, is equal to 0.24 ampere, first answer, and the voltmeter reading, which is nothing but V3 here, which is 2.88 volts, second answer. So that concludes this question. One more question and you can give the test. Okay, example, 12.8. This will be on page 225, I guess. Okay, so slowly we'll do it and see that. In the circuit diagram, 12.10, which is on page 224. Look into your text and let us draw the diagram. So here, the diagram something like this. Okay, let us just go a little bit on. Here, one more. And then down here, one more. Like this, I see something like this. Then here, down here comes. And one cell, long, two, long, short, three, one, two, three. One, two, three, four, I think, one more. We know that the short one is negative, and the longer one is positive. And then we see here a switch. And then goes to an emitter. So here, this is the diagram. Emitter to measure current, always in series, not above or below resistors. And we see here, this is R1. Given in the question there, R1 is given as 5, 10, 30, so 5 ohms. R2 here is given 10 ohms, and R3, the third one, is given as 30 ohms. 5, 10, 30, yes. So as you switch on, current always flow from positive towards negative. So I comes here. Total I. Let us say this is 10 ampere. Just to explain here, some of the total 10 will go here, I1. Some will go here, I2. Some will go here, I3. Because there is additional path in parallel. That's why it will not be same. 3 ampere, 2 ampere, 5 ampere. And then 5 ampere again. Then total is coming out here again, 10. But here it is distributed, divided into 2, 3, 5 or something like that. That's why current through the different resistors in parallel is never same, because they are divided into different paths. Okay, we have learned this in the first class of this test. Now we have to start doing the thing. So let us go there. A, you can directly start, I think. Just follow closely, slowly you get it. A, the current through each resistor. So here, current through, we have marked here I1 as through R1. So let I1, I2, I3 be the current. Find the current through each resistor. So current through first resistor, R1. I1 is through R1, equal to 5 ohms. Then R2 equal to 10 ohms. So I2 is the current through the 10 ohm resistors, and R3 equal to 30 ohms. So I3 is the current through 30. We have to find this. Now using Ohm's law. Very easy, because we need to find I, means we need V and R. So V, let us, okay, before Ohm's law, we need V. So let us, I think we can do using Ohm's law. We have already explained, so we can understand now. So V is equal to I into R, we know that. But specifically, we have to find, in this case, the V. Everything is in this one here. Now the voltage is total current and the total circuit and total circuit resistance. Okay, so here 1 voltmeter is connected, which is not necessary, I think, but you can just connect like that textbook V. Okay, now here V here, okay, total V will be same, because in parallel we know that the voltage across R1, R2, R3 will be same, because they are between the same 2 points. They will have the same voltage as the battery. Now if you go to textbook, connected to 12 volt battery, so this is total from here to here is nothing but 12 volt. So here that is V is there, we can use that same one. I, we have to put I1, and since it I1 is passing through R1, put here R1. So that implies I1 will be equal to this V divided by R, will come down, R1. So I1 can be equal to, V is here, as we see, 12 volts in the diagram also, divided by R1 here is 5 ohms. So you divide this and you'll get 5 2s are 10, 2 9, 5 4s are 20. Volt by ohm is ampere, so we write here one, equation number 1, 2.4 ampere. Then similarly here, I2 will be equal to, directly I'm going here, okay, I2 equal to V by R2. V will be same in all 3 cases because they are in parallel. V is always same, right? In series is different. We learned that in the first class. So that will be equal to, okay, here itself we can do it, 12 volts by 10 ohms. So very easy. 10 divided by 10 is this, will move one place to the left between 1 and 2, so 1.2 ampere, equation number 2. Then next, I3, similarly, V by R3, which is equal to 12 volt by 30 ohms. So smartly, we can just change this to 3 tens are 30, 3 fours are 12. That way, don't cancel anymore, because 0 is easy to divide. So the symbol will go one place to the left of 4, so 0.4 on the left now. Ampere. This is equation number 3. So current through each resistors 2.4, 1.2 and 0.4 ampere fan out. Directly we can go to B, and B is saying total. Okay, B is total current in the circuit. So let us put here I question mark. Total current in the circuit. Common sense only. So I. So I1, I2, I3 coming out together. I means this I1, 2, 3 added will give you total current. I1 plus I2 plus I3. Very simple. So I1 is in equation number 1, as you see. 2.4 ampere plus 1.2 ampere plus here 0.4 ampere, and we can write here since using equations 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so when we add this, we're going to get here 2.4, 1.2 and 0.4. So 10, 1, and 3, 4. So 4.0 means simply 4 ampere. Equation number 4, let us say. So total current also found out. C finally. Finally, C is total circuit resistance. Now this resistance is clearly in parallel, so the total will be in parallel. So let RP be the total resistance of the R1 equal to how much? 5 ohms, R2 equal to 10 ohms, and R3 equal to 30 ohms, very clearly in parallel. This is important that we know which parallel or series. So if it's in parallel, then he writes here reciprocal of total 1, that means 1 by RP equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, because parallel formula is this. That gives you here 1 by RP equal to 1 by 5 ohms plus 1 by 10 ohms plus 1 by 30 ohms. So here 30 ohms, 5, 10 and 30. So let us continue to do. So that gives you by RP equal to LCM of 5, 10 and 30 is 30. So let us put here 30 ohms. Then here denominator 5, 6 are 30. 6 ones are 6 plus 10 threes are 30. 3 ones are 3 plus 30 ones are 30, 1 ones are 1. So you're going to get here 1 by RP is equal to 6, 10. If you add 6 plus 3 plus 1, 10 by 30 ohms. 0, 0 cancelled. Now you cross multiply down and up. RP into 1. RP down and up or up and down. 1 into 3. 3 ohms. So this is equation number. Following this, 5. At this point, let me remind you one thing. When the resistances are in parallel, okay, which is the smallest among the three? 5, 10, 30? Yes, very simple, 5. When they are in parallel, the total will come out lesser than the smallest. Smallest is 5. Total is 3C. Always, when in parallel, the total resistance is always lesser than the smallest individual resistance. Individually, 5 is smaller. But the total is going to be even smaller than the smallest. But if it's in series, which is the largest, biggest, 30 years. In series, the total will become higher than, total will be bigger than the biggest individual one. So if you want more resistance, we do in series. If you want lesser, we do it in parallel. It's, objectives may come out, that's why I'm asking. In series, the total will be greater than the greatest individual resistance. In parallel, total will be lesser than the least individual resistance, as you can see here. 3 ohms lesser than 5 even. Okay, so this ends the thing, but we can write the final answer. So we can write here number A. Current through each of the resistors. Question is asking this first. So simply I1 equal to 2.4 ampere. I2 equal to 1.2 ampere. I3 equal to I3 equal to 0.4 ampere. And you can write here since using equations 1, 2, and 3. This is the first answer. The next one, B. We'll go to question if you want. Total current they're asking. So you just write here, total current in the circuit. We have decided to denote it by I, so if you want, you write it, is equal to here 4 ampere. And this we get by using equation number 4. First answer, second answer, then C. Total current, total circuit resistance. So total resistance, you can simply write like that, total resistance or total circuit resistance, the way you like it, R. P, we have decided to put like this, is equal to, there are 3 ohms. 3 ohms, and you write here, since using equation number 5. So these are the ABC answers. That concludes the part. You can go and give the test 9, 12, D, sorry. Okay.